I'm going to talk first about the process from the health minister first asked for medicine-free, drug-free treatment to be implemented in the health regions of Norway. He asked twice nicely. That didn't work, so then he told them, start planning, and you should be ready by 1st of June 2016. And they did start planning, and they did start implementing, and nobody was finished by 1st of June 2016. They asked for help from some of the members' organizations, the user organizations in Norway, and they did. Some did a very good job up in Tromsø. They did a very good job, and they very solid. And others did a. The important thing was, should patients have the possibility to choose mental health care without medication? We have Jan Ove Risberg here, who says no, they shouldn't, because the evidence for this being a good treatment isn't strong enough. He thinks it's a bad idea. I would like to lift the voice of somebody who disagrees, a user. Her name is Elina, and she wrote a blog post 6 days ago about medication-free alternatives. Her blog address is there. I suggest you take a look at it. Perhaps she's sitting next to you. I know she asked for, I asked for her permission to use her post in my presentation, and she said yes. She said she wanted to ask for permission to leave the hospital. She's in a locked mental ward, and she didn't have a choice going in there, so she wasn't sure if she could get out. She's 25 years old. I put up the Norwegian post here, and I'll read the English, so those of you who wish can stick with the Norwegian. What she write is, I've lost count of how many times I've been given drugs against my will. I wouldn't wish this for anybody. It has made me lose valuable time of my youth, time I can never regain. I remember thinking that the nurses gave me and other patients drugs to make their job easier. Naturally, it's much more comfortable to work with a gang of zombies than to play cat and mouse all the time. But the thought scared me. Today, I know it isn't so. I choose to believe in the good in people. I believe that the nurses had the wish to help, not drug me to remove my personality. That was what I felt happened. I said so, but I wasn't heard. It hurt. More than all the pain of the needles, it hurts even to think about it. Even today, I would rather be psychotic than to use antipsychotics. I've heard others say the same, and there must be a reason for this. Unfortunately, we are many who have been forcefully drugged and been traumatized by this. I'm afraid that experiences such as this can lead people to losing their trust in the people who are actually there to help. I am no way an expert in medicine. I'm not a doctor. I'm only a human being. A human being who knows a whole lot about the disadvantages of forced drugging. I stand firm by the conviction that patients should have the liberty to choose not to take drugs as long as it's defendable. Naturally, medicines may be of help to some people, but for people who are as strongly opposed to them as I am, alternative solutions should be found, because help can be found that doesn't feature psychotropic drugs. Bent Høie recently said something about people being different and experiencing treatment in different ways. With medication-free alternatives, patients are taken seriously. Patients are experts in their own health. It makes me happy to hear that other people feel the same. We have to take care of and have our autonomy respected. There are so many patients in psychiatric healthcare who don't want to be treated with drugs. They must be listened to and taken seriously. There are many other ways to give necessary care and treatment. Talking therapy, cognitive therapy, are just a couple of examples. It's time to use some creativity. If one decides to treat patients with psychotropic agents without their consent, several criteria must be fulfilled. These people must have, first of all, a serious mental health issue. Alone, this is not enough. They must pose a danger to their own or other people's lives, or it must be evident that the medication will lessen the chance of the illness becoming worse. I have not been in danger for myself or others. I've been psychotic and I've been scared, very scared. Fear should not be medicated away. Being scared while being involuntarily committed to a closed psychiatric ward is, in my point of view, a normal reaction to an abnormal situation. Having said all this, I do not oppose to all medication. I think they can help many. I use some drugs today, and they work well for me. I don't like it, but I understand it's for the best. What I'm concerned with is that everybody should be given a real choice. You should be allowed to select not to take drugs if you don't want to, and to choose some other treatment in which you believe. I believe that with people should be respected as human beings and not just seen as another psychotic case. Is that possible? Yes, I definitely think so. If you don't try that, it will be a major mistake. I think that she puts forward in words much better my point. I think this is a very strong way of saying we need alternatives. It's not good enough just to throw some Zyprexa or whatever antipsychotic medicine or antidepressants or whatever. It's not good enough. You have to talk with people. You have to find out what is your wish, what is your dream, what is your history. Don't ask them what's wrong with you. Ask what happened with you. That's important. Then you can touch people and you can help them find a better life. Thank you.